Another day, another video, and another bike review. So, what do we have today? This is what we have on the menu today. The Honda CB300R from Honda's Neo Sports Cafe family. It's a looker, it's a performer, and it's also pricey. But what else is it? We find out in today's video. The CB300R sports a very charming and very handsome look. Honda has styled it nicely, even though it's got a bit of the retro DNA. It has modern touches like the completely LED lit headlamp, turn indicators and tail lamp. The turn indicators are very sleek and stylish. Even the levers have been given this metallic finish. The upside down forks add to the looks. Then moving back on the side, you will see that you have these plastic bits and bobs which Honda has added, and while they are plastic bits, they do look really nice. You do not have any grab rails for the pillion, but there is plenty of space for a pillion rider, and the seat cushion is pretty comfortable. Only on long journeys did I feel that it could have been slightly better and softer. And over at the back you will find the muffler, which again looks fantastic. This bike is powered by a 286cc liquid cooled single cylinder engine, which can produce about 30 horsepower and 27.4 newton meters of torque. Thankfully, the engine has been tuned in such a way that despite the peak power and torque coming in high at 8,000 and 6,500 RPM respectively, there is a lot of low-end power in this bike. So from the get-go, the bike is ready to plunge. You can easily pop the front tire in the first gear. So there is a lot of meat for you to easily overtake anyone on the road. Sadly though, once you cross about 6,000 RPM, there are a lot of vibrations with the engine. So Honda really, really needs to work on that and have a smoother engine. The 6-speed gearbox is probably my favorite part of this bike, other than the low-end acceleration, because it's so smooth and it's so precise that you could probably shift this barefoot. The gears slot in perfectly. Even getting to neutral is very easy. You don't accidentally go to the first or the second gear, and the gears have a nice click to them, so you know when you have shifted. Coming to the brakes, you have a disc brake on the front as well as on the rear tire, and you have dual channel ABS. There is an IMU which controls the deceleration, and it works well for the most part. It's just that I felt that the rear brake lacked a little bit of bite when compared to the front. The front is fantastic. You get good progression and great feel from the front brake. The suspension setup has been tuned quite nicely for usage in the city. It will absorb most of the bumps and brakes on the tarmac. The rear monoshock is a little stiff, but it is 7-step adjustable. The ground clearance is also ample at 151 mm, so going over tall speed breakers, again, you won't have a problem. In the short while that we had, I took this bike for rides as long as 1.5 hours, and still I found myself decently comfortable. The mileage figure that we got from our small testing was close to 32 to 33 kilometers per liter in city usage. You could get more or less depending on your riding style. But what bothers me a little is the small 10 liter fuel tank. Agreed with a mileage like this, which is quite good, you could get a nice range, but still a bigger fuel tank would have helped for people who want to go on longer journeys. So this is the LCD instrument cluster that comes with the CB300R. You have these two buttons to switch between the various modes. Now I do have a problem with these buttons because they're a little hard to press, but once you do use them, you can see that you have two trip meters, you have a lap timer, a total distance that you've covered, it shows you your current average, the mileage that you can get, the range that you have and the average speed. You also see the time and your RPM gauge as well as the fuel level indicator. Oddly, Honda did not put in a gear position indicator, but you do have a shift indicator which lights up. I really like the CB300R for its agile, nimble and lightweight characteristics. Even the low end power that it has is really likable, but then it does have some odd ergonomic choices, and the engine is YB. It is priced at 2.41 lakh rupees ex showroom Delhi. What this means is that it is a little bit pricey. If you wanted a cruiser, you could get a more powerful bike by paying a little less, but I think even Honda knows that and they're not expecting this to sell in loads. This in fact comes under their exclusive Silverwing brand, so what you're paying for is a little premiumness, a little bit of that design and that lightweight character that this bike has and the maneuverability that this bike has. Let me know if you would be interested in owning something niche like this, or if you would rather go for something which is more conventional. As always, make sure that you like this video if you liked the information that was provided. Comment down below if you have any questions. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, like our page on Facebook, follow us on Instagram and Twitter as well. This is Akash signing off. Until the next time, bye bye.